Hello everyone.
Welcome back to our second session all together. How was your break? Was your break fun or not? Anyway, I hope that you really enjoyed your break. So now let's move to our second session all together that we focus on listening express one in the 8 for funs. So for 4 funs today, we focus on page 70. So please open the book on this page all together so that you can see our today lesson. So we focus on warm up listening that we have two parts. We have A and B. So A, choose T for true or F for false. This means that you have to listen from the audio track and then read about the sentences here. Are they right or wrong? If they are wrong, it is mean a false. But if they are right, it is mean true. All right, everyone, I hope you can understand about how to do this. Now the show will let you play it 3 times for you guys to do, and then we can check the answer together. Let's start.
Warm up listening.
Did your mom make all this food, Bobby?
I helped a bit. I made the pie.
I'll try some. Thanks for inviting me to your Thanksgiving dinner. My family doesn't celebrate this holiday.
Don't you do anything special in fall, Yuna?
My family celebrates a Korean holiday called Chuseok.
What do you do on Chuseok?
We give thanks to family members who have died. We also make food together. After that, we play games and have a huge feast. That's my favorite part.
That sounds a little like Thanksgiving Day. We have a feast too. It really is the best part.
Good job, everyone. All right, so now it's time for you to check the answer with the teacher, right? Let's check the answer with the teacher altogether. Now, one. So, Chuseok is a Korean holiday. Chuseok is a Korean holiday. Is it true or false? Yeah, great. It is true, right? Alright, and let's go to number 2. Yuna have made the pie. Yuna have made the pie. Is it Yuna or Bobby? Alright, great job. It's Bobby. So the answer should be false. Let's go to number 3. Bobby's family celebrate Chuseok. So Bobby's family is not in the Korea and they are not born in Korea too. So what? So it's false that they celebrate about that one. So their family celebrate about what? About Thanksgiving, right? Thanksgiving. All right, so I hope that you got the answer the same as the teacher. Now let's move to B. Listen again, fill in the blanks. This means that you have to listen again and then fill in the blank based on the question here, right? All right, so now the teacher would like to play this one 3 times again for you guys to complete the answer. Let's start all together.
Warm up listening.
Did your mom make all this food, Bobby?
I helped a bit. I made the pie.
I'll try some. Thanks for inviting me to your Thanksgiving dinner. My family doesn't celebrate this holiday.
Don't you do anything special in fall, Yuna?
My family celebrates a Korean holiday called Chuseok.
What do you do on Chuseok?
We give thanks to family members who have died. We also make food together. After that, we play games and have a huge feast. That's my favorite part.
That sounds a little like Thanksgiving Day. We have a feast too. It really is the best part.
Brilliant, everyone. All right. I hope that your answers are correct. Now let's check all together. So the question number 1. What are 2 things that Yuna's family does on Chuseok? So, the first one, you can see that they make food together. So, you have the answer for the first one is make food, right? So, they make food together. Number 2, they play, and put stop. So, they play what? Play games. All right, let's move to number 2. What do Thanksgiving and Chuseok have in common? So in common, this means like it's similar. So the first one, they are both in the season of what? The season of falls. All right. And then people have a big what? You can say a big feast, or some of you might say a big meal. It's still correct, big feast or big meal. All right, everyone, so I hope that you can feel more familiar about the fall fun, because it seems like the lesson describes about the four seasons, right? So now our today lesson is finished. If there's still any questions, you can ask your home teacher for more detail. So at the end of the lesson, teacher would like to say that please don't forget to protect yourself during this time, like wear mask or share mask before you go out. So now our today lesson is finished. See you again tomorrow. Goodbye and good luck, everyone.